A surprise announcement from the Nobel Committee. President Obama was named the winner of the Nobel Peace Prize. The award is given to encourage the president's initiatives, which include cutting nuclear weapons, easing tensions with the Muslim world, and emphasizing diplomacy. It was a decision that shocked even those in the audience.
The Nobel Peace Prize for 2009 is to be awarded to President Barack Obama for his extraordinary efforts.
Obama was nominated less than 2 weeks into his presidency to meet the February deadline for the prize. The Nobel Committee did recognize that so far Mr. Obama's measures have not borne any fruit. And we certainly agree with that. But at the same time, we congratulate him. And we congratulate him for the promise of bringing peace and encourage that perhaps we could get rid of nuclear weapons and we could stop Iran from getting a nuclear bomb. We could see peace actually come to the Middle East. We could have better relations with Arabs in the Middle East. We could have all of these things. But again, you just... I tell you, Terry, you shake your head on this one. How did he get nominated just 2 weeks into his presidency? And why is this so focused on the promise of the presidency rather than the results so far?
Could have doesn't seem like it should be the criteria for winning the prize. I mean, has done would seem like that ought to be what it's premised on.
Well, if I were advising him, I would say you might want to turn it down and say, reconsider once these things come to be. Wendy Griffith has more from the CBN newsroom. Wendy?
Gordon, the House of Representatives has passed a controversial hate crimes bill giving new protections to homosexuals and other groups. But Christians warn the bill could have a chilling effect on the freedom of religion. The bill did not pass on a straight up or down vote. Instead, it was attached to a defense spending measure. Jennifer Wishon has that story from Washington.
Although the legislation is designed to help U.S. troops,
I sadly urge my colleagues to vote against the defense authorization bill.
That's because supporters added the hate crimes bill to the defense package. Hate crimes legislation adds homosexuals and transgendered Americans to the list of already protected classes of race, religion, and national origin. Supporters say the bill is necessary.
Between 1998 and 2007, more than 77,000 hate crime incidents were reported. And the trend is up for hate crimes based on sexual orientation.
Texas Congressman Louie Gohmert says Christians denounce violence against anyone, but argues there are already laws on the books to deal with such crimes that are in many cases tougher. And he says Congress should not attach language to a defense bill that weakens constitutional rights of free speech and freedom of religion, including the freedom to preach on sexual morality.
We're going to take away the freedoms of people of faith to stand up and read Romans 1 in public. Because if you read Romans 1 in public and you get to verse 25 and some nut hears that and goes out and commits an act of violence, you can be arrested because you induced him.
Some late changes were made to the bill to strengthen protections for religious speech, but not everyone believes they're enough. The full Senate could vote on it as soon as next week. President Obama has said he will sign it into law. Jennifer Wishon, CBN News, Washington.
Flash floods and mudslides in the northern Philippines have killed well over 160 people, and that number expected to rise. That brings the overall death toll to more than 450 people. The Philippines is experiencing the worst flooding it's seen in 40 years, caused by back-to-back typhoons. Nonstop rain is making rescue efforts difficult. An Israeli medical team flew to Manila today to help the Filipino people devastated by the typhoons. Operation Blessing Israel played a key role in connecting Israeli medical experts with the Operation Blessing team on the ground in the Philippines.
The connection between the Operation Blessing's connection for us to get to the Philippines was a really crucial one, because it opened for us doors that before were actually closed.
We've been working with our Philippines Operation Blessing with Dr. Kim in order to receive them and to immediately plug the team into the relief effort now going on in the Philippines and also going on in the north in the Philippines.
Indonesian search teams are still looking for survivors from last week's massive earthquake. Operation Blessing was able to help victims of the quake in a remote area near the center of that quake, but only after one TV cameraman made sure the relief team had a way to reach them. George Thomas has this amazing story.
This is where Raymond Sitoris is most comfortable, behind a camera, documenting Operation Blessing's disaster relief work in the earthquake zone.
But this week, Raymond found himself in the uncomfortable position of trying to convince an Indonesian police chief to loan him this helicopter.
I was filming at an Operation Blessing medical outreach when an earthquake survivor told me there was a village close to the epicenter that had not yet been reached by aid workers.
The location was remote and all the roads leading to the village had been destroyed in the quake.
I went to the local police chief and asked if we could use his helicopter to go to this village and check for survivors. He looked at me as if I was crazy and said it was not possible.
But Raymond would not take no for an answer. Finally, the police chief agreed, but reluctantly. So, on Thursday morning, Raymond, several Operation Blessing doctors, and a couple of Indonesian police officers set out for the village of Ambachang Gadang. What they saw as they approached the village was shocking. Several massive landslides had engulfed the village.
I didn't think anyone could have survived this kind of devastation.
Dozens of people had survived, and Raymond began to document what he saw and heard.
We've had no water, no rice, nothing to eat. We've been living on coconut juice for the last 5 days.
Everywhere Raymond pointed the camera, there was devastation. Homes completely flattened, roads split in half. 17-year-old Zeno Abiu was caught in one of the landslides.
I was hit by a huge wall of mud. I was tumbling down this mountain completely buried. I could not breathe. I thought I was going to die.
Raymond met another survivor, 49-year-old Emira. She too had an amazing story.
This is what's left of my home. In seconds, it was all gone, flattened by the earthquake.
The police officer asked the villagers what they needed.
We need blankets, we need rice, tent, food, water, clothes.
That's when the Indonesian police chief, who had been so reluctant to help, turned to Raymond and the Operation Blessing team and smiled. Minutes later, the helicopter was making the return flight to base. An hour later, it was back with boxes of relief supplies from Operation Blessing.
Today is the first time that I will have a meal because of you.
The Operation Blessing doctors immediately set up camp and began to examine each villager. For the man behind the camera documenting the moment, there was a sense of personal satisfaction, but he refused to take credit.
The real heroes are the men and women who volunteer for Operation Blessing and those who make it possible to help my people who are suffering.
Operation Blessing had favor not just with the villagers.
Thank you, Operation Blessing. Thank you.
And also with the Indonesian police force.
The police chief told me that whenever we need to ferry supplies, we can count on them and they will let us use the helicopter for free.
George Thomas, CBN News, Padang, Indonesia.
Gordon, it's amazing how remote some of these villages are, but thanks to God, Operation Blessing was able to find these people.
That's right, and thanks to you. If you're a member of the 700 Club, you're part of that. You heard that thank you going out from that cameraman, that it's because people like you care enough to give. A portion of every gift to the 700 Club goes into the work of Operation Blessing to bring hope to people around the world. And it's because of faithful partners like you that all of this is possible. Operation Blessing Indonesia has been in existence for a decade now, and you see the results of what happens when you have dedicated people that say, we won't let any obstacle get in our way. We want to get relief to people in need. You know, if we can't get there within 24 hours, we've failed in our mission. That's how they think, and you're part of that because you're giving. If you're not a member, now's the time to join. If you want to be a part of everything we're doing, if you want to be a part of medical teams flying from Israel to the Philippines in order to help, if you want to be part of the Philippine flood relief, if you want to be part of the earthquake relief in Indonesia, join the 700 Club. We're a lot more than just a TV show. We're reaching out with hands of love and compassion around the world. And our motto is, when disaster strikes, we want to strike back with love and compassion to bring help to people in need.